All these tools are fitted with a safety feature, lift detector switch, simple mechanical device that senses any kind of movement and then shuts the motor off. There's an interlock system on this, so if that switch is not engaged, we can't start the motor. Doesn't matter if you have the magnet on, without that switch engaged, it just won't work. The unit comes with a D-ring. This is for your safety chain. So if you're on a structure, you can clip the one end on this one, wrap it around, come back around, and reattach to the D-ring. Should you lose magnetism or electrical supply, the magnet's gonna drop dead and the unit could fall and create some problems. We've got another unit sitting up over here where we've got it all set up to drill. This is the same model, but it also incorporates a swivel feature. Basically, we've set the tool in place, and now we can swing it around front to back, right to left, and find the hole location that we want to drill on. Then it's just a matter of locking the tool down and drilling your hole. Let me get into a little bit better spot here. Some of these units do come with a coolant feature or a bottle that sits off to the side. It's a gravity-fed system that will follow the tool right down and put the coolant right down through the center of the tool. But in this particular situation, we're going to go ahead and fill this little cup or reservoir at the arbor, and that will give us enough cutting fluid for at least one, maybe two cuts. I'm going to go ahead and start this. Once you establish a groove, you can go ahead and put more pressure on it. You want to apply pressure until you just start to hear that motor work a little bit. Let the motor do the work. And we've just drilled 1 1/16 diameter hole through about 1/2 inch thick structural steel. And there's your slug.